Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make a cool-looking illustration of your favorite car from a regular photo. Choose a side view photo of your favorite car. If you'd like to use this photo of a Viper, I provided its link in the video description or project files. Your car needs to be on a white background. In order to do this, you need to make a selection around your car, invert the selection, and fill it with white. I covered how to make selections in many of my tutorials, so I won't be going over it here. The size of this document is 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Make two copies of your image by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac twice. We'll name the top layer Pencil and the layer below it Color. Click off the eyeballs of the top two layers to hide them, and click on the thumbnail of the bottom layer to make it active. Click on the foreground color to open the color picker. Next to the B for brightness, type in 90%. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Now we have 90% gray as the foreground color. We'll fill the background with the foreground color by pressing Alt-Delete on Windows or Option-Delete on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. Choose Sandstone and make the scaling 100%, the Relief 3, and Top for Light. Then click OK. This will give texture to the color that we add later. Make the pencil layer visible and active. Remove all its color by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-U. To automatically apply the Levels command to your image, press Ctrl or Command-Shift-L to invoke Autotone. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Texture folder and open Stylize. Click on Glowing Edges. For this photo, I'll make the Edge Width 1, the Edge Brightness 6, and the Smoothness 7. For your photo, experiment with these numbers to get similar results as this. If you have white lines surrounding the edges, remove them with your pencil tool. First, press D on your keyboard to make the foreground and background colors default to black and white. Choose a medium to large size tip and make the hardness 100%. Now, draw around the edges to cover the white lines. Invert your image by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Make a copy of the pencil layer and name it Lines. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Threshold. Slide the threshold level to the right until there's just enough lines to recognize it. For this example, the threshold is 215. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 0 and the distance between 900 and 950 pixels. This will be our speed lines. Change the blend mode to darken. Make the pencil layer active and change its blend mode to darken as well. Make the color layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to linear light. We're ready to add text. Make the top layer active. We'll place our text above it. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Batman Forever Alternate. You can download it from fontzone.com. The size is 70 points, sharp, left alignment, and the color is black. Type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Reduce its fill to 0%. Click on the FX icon and choose Bevel and Emboss. Make the style Inner Bevel, the technique Chisel Hard, the direction Up, and the size 0. Check Contour, then click OK. Make a copy of the text and double-click on Bevel and Emboss to open it in the Layer Style window. Uncheck Global Light, make the angle minus 50 degrees, and the altitude 25 degrees. Then click OK. I'd like to slide this text copy to the left and up, so I'll press on the left arrow on my keyboard 4 times and the up arrow 4 times. Next, we'll add accent lines and then angle the entire word. Make a copy of the top layer and go to Layer, Rasterize, and Layer Style. Make a copy of it and name the top layer Vertical Lines and the layer below it Horizontal Lines. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Keep the angle 0 degrees and make the distance 90 pixels. We'll repeat this for the vertical accent lines. Make the vertical lines layer active and go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Go to the line on the edge of the circle and press and hold Shift as you rotate it until it snaps 90 degrees. Then click OK. Next, we'll angle the entire word. Shift-click on the bottom text layer to highlight all the layers between it and the top active layer. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Go to the top middle point and press and hold Ctrl-Shift-Alt on Windows or Command-Shift-Option on a Mac. When you see this horizontal double arrow, drag it to the right or left until you're happy with the angle. Then press Enter or Return. To reposition it, simply click on it and move it. I'd like to make the lines of the words a bit stronger, but first, let's place all the text layers into a folder. Press Ctrl or Command G. I'll type in Text on Top. We'll be adding text at the bottom in a few minutes. Make a copy of the folder. Because we have two of the same text layers on top of each other, our text becomes stronger. Notice the difference as I toggle back and forth. Next, we'll place the huge cropped name of the car at the bottom. Open your type tool and type out your text. Click on your Move tool and open Transform. Move the text to the corner and go to the upper right corner of the transform. When you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out. Make it as large as you want and feel free to crop it if you like. Use the same steps as you did for the text at the top. The reason we just didn't enlarge the smaller text is because the lines would have gotten thicker and softer. Next, we'll add this watercolor effect. Make the text on top copy active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. Click on the foreground color and click on a color of your car to pick up that particular color. Then click OK. Open your brush tool and click on the arrow next to the point size. Click on the gear icon and choose Wet Media Brushes. Click OK to see just this set in the thumbnail window. Click on the gear icon again and choose Large List. Scroll down and choose a watercolor brush. For this example, I'll choose Watercolor Fat Tip. To make your brush larger, press the right bracket key on your keyboard. The size of this brush is 300 pixels. Now, brush across the bottom of your document. I'll brush across once more a little higher. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.